So, tip number one, find an elevated counter, preferably one against a wall. This is probably the most important tip when it comes to blow drying your cat. I am going to try to make Torchy as comfortable as possible. Torchy is my 11-month-old flame point Himalayan. He was recently neutered last month, so he has some shave patches on his rear abdomen and left forearm where his IV was placed, so just ignore those for this video. I also recently gave him a comb cup and took some length off, so his hair appears a little bit shorter in length than that of an 11-month-old Persian. So for tip number two, make sure your cat is as comfortable as you could expect. And by this, I mean just place a dry towel underneath him or her. For whatever reason, sitting on towels comforts them. Trust me, it works. It also probably has something to do with keeping their paw pads warm. For blow drying, I like to use a Dyson supersonic hair dryer. I like this one because it's relatively quiet compared to its other blow drying counterparts. And I'm going to insert a clip where you can actually hear the sound this dryer emits. I know a lot of show breeders and groomers actually recommend against using personal blow dryers on cats due to the risk of burning their skin. However, I completely disagree with that assertion. A cat's average internal body temperature is about 101.5, which is 3 degrees lower than a human's, so essentially it's impossible to burn your cat with a personal blow dryer if you're constantly moving it. Obviously, if you hold the hair dryer at a close range for over 10 seconds without moving it, you can risk burning your cat. I personally hand blow dry my cats, so I'm constantly changing the directionality of the airflow and never holding it in one place stagnantly. So I've never had any of my cats exhibit distress signs from the blow dryer or the heat. And they like this dryer as opposed to some of the other dryers I've tried to use. This is a game of love, and it was you, and it was you, the one that would be breaking my heart, when you decided to walk away, when I wanted you to stay. For tip number three, as most people already know, remember to blow dry the hair against the direction of hair growth. This ensures that the hair dries at a faster rate while also promoting coat volume.
just wanted you to stay. Me, I just wanted you to stay.
Okay, for tip number 4, always test the temperature of the air on yourself just to make sure it's not too hot or being held too close to the skin. Also, when you move onto the chest or any regions near their face, you want to make sure you're on the lowest drying and heat speed. It's easy to forget this. Sometimes I have made that mistake, so don't make that mistake. Tried to get a shot of me blow drying his tail. It's my favorite part to dry on my cats. Like the rest of the coat, you want to make sure you blow dry against the direction of hair growth to achieve maximum volume. I like to start at the base of the tail and then work towards the tip. The tail dries faster that way. The one that would be breaking my heart. To blow dry the hind legs, I kind of coax them to offer up their leg to me. Extending the hind legs while drying helps ensure that you don't leave any damp areas in the bends. Once they're about 90% dry, give or take, I move back to the chest and work there. If you can, I suggest picking up one arm at a time and blowing the armpits the best you can. The armpits are notorious for retaining moisture, which can lead to matting if not adequately dried. So if you can gain access, I would.
And it was you. I just wanted you to stay.
So here you can see me lightly pinching Torchy's ear. This is another important tip to utilize whenever you are drying near their face or cheeks. Remember to pinch their ears or cover their ears somehow because air to the ear severely agitates them. Now that he's dry, I removed the towel and proceeded to fluff him and feel around just to make sure I didn't miss any areas while blow drying. After blow drying, I like to comb out my cat's coats because bathing tends to loosen any dead hair. I recommend using an Andis 7.5-inch steel comb or any steel greyhound comb. So this is the wisest tip in the book. Say you're drying your cat and you think you're done, and you put the dryer down. Well, you're not done, so pick it back up and blow dry for at least 2 more minutes just to make sure the coat is truly dry. You don't want mats. Trust me, I know this from experience. Oh wow, look at all the hair. This is why it's important to brush your cat before and after bathing. I comb down all my cats before bathing and after I'm done blow drying. Some people do prefer combing while blow drying, but I just do it after because I think it's easier. Lastly, I like to use a finishing spray to wrap things up. Here, I'm using Ice on Ice by Chris Christensen. It's actually a multi-purpose spray that can be used for dematting as well as repelling dirt. I use it to reduce static and condition the coat for a nice finishing effect. Just lightly spritz and give a quick blow dry, and you are all done.
There is a game of love. There is a-